Well, basically, I'm a macroeconomist, right? And my interests are in things like endogenous growth, okay, R&D, and also in teaching wise, also on money and banking. I have taught money and banking 1, money and banking 2, and also macroeconomic analysis 3 over the past 10 years, over the past 5 years or so. And those are actually my main both teaching and research interests. First of all, I mean, one thing I should mention is that I have not taught any financial economics, right? I've taught money and banking, macroeconomics, right? So if students want to do well in specialization, then they also want to, they should take 1 or 2 financial economics courses as well, right? Okay. I think there's courses like financial economics, there's financial forecasting, financial market microstructure. You don't have to take all of them, but you should take at least 1 or 2 of them, right? So then a lot of it depends also on the student's career objectives, you know. If they want to work in the banking and finance, obviously these courses will help them a lot because they have a much better understanding of the banking and financial system. And they understand it better not only in terms of descriptive knowledge, which can they easily pick up later on when they start working, but in terms of understanding the analytical foundations, okay, what's happening in the real world, right? So one important thing is to understand, to be familiar with the intricacies of the monetary and banking system. Okay, for example, why do we have deposit insurance? Okay, and what are the advantages and risks of deposit insurance? Why do we have capital adequacy requirements on banks? What roles do they play, and so on? So this course will provide them with a good, the good analytical understanding of these fundamental issues. Right. There are micro benefits in understanding the banking system, okay, the operation of banks, and also from a macro point of view, they also understand the wider systemic context. Okay, what is the monetary and banking system all about? Okay, how does inflation, okay, affect the economy? That's where the cash and advance models are particularly relevant. Okay, so why is inflation bad? Okay, and then they can also, should also understand the overall macroeconomic context. So we need to have both a micro perspective and macro perspective, and the course aims to provide information or knowledge of both. For money and banking 1, there's less emphasis on mathematics. I mean, there is some, but it's significantly less, okay? Right? So students have to have a knowledge of basic calculus, and let's say basic statistics, right? When it comes to the money and banking 2 and macroeconomics 3, these are 4,000 level modules, and they will require more intensive knowledge of calculus. For example, constraint optimization. What I find is that students sometimes they know the mathematical tools, but they are not very clear how to apply the tools to solve particular economic problems. You know, so it's not just a matter of knowing the technique, but being able to relate the technique to the economic problem that you are studying. I like to tell my students that for these courses, required reading is the Straits Times. Okay? It's a fast changing world, right? And there are a lot of interesting information provided in the Straits Times, not just factual information, but also an analysis of the data. So, I mean, if you really want to do well, for example, I mean, this digital banking is a very new development, right? You won't find much about it or hardly anything in the textbooks, but it is discussed at quite length in the Straits Times. Okay? So one has to have an awareness of current issues, also of current macroeconomic developments, both in Singapore and the world as a whole. Right? So it's very important to have an awareness of current issues. And sometimes I might ask questions which require them to give examples from the real world, right? Which I think is quite important. Right? So you also require awareness of current issues. Okay. Another very important thing is to have immersion in the topics. Normally, when I set problems in the tutorials or midterm or final exam, okay, the problems themselves are not so difficult, provided that you know the material very well. So first, you have to immerse in the lecture material and the readings thoroughly and be fully clear about not just the results, but the logic that leads to the results. From an analytical standpoint, the logic and so on. And then you find that it's much easier to do the problems. But if students just jump to the problems without really having a thorough understanding of the material, then they will just go round and round in circles. It's not going to work, right? So you have to have immersion, right, in the topics, thorough immersion, right? And also, what is required is the cultivation of an analytical problem-solving mindset. It's not just a matter of, you know, simply repeating whatever you have been taught. That no longer works nowadays, okay? The problems are there to test your understanding of how to manipulate the material to answer particular issues, okay? There's also a lot of scope for work in the public sector, you know. Mm. If you want to join the Monetary Authority of Singapore, then these courses are very helpful, okay? Because the Monetary Authority of Singapore studies the monetary and banking system, the macroeconomic environment in great detail, right? So this provides, I think, extremely important knowledge for somebody wanting to go into the MAS. MTI also, and MTI is more focused on trade and growth and investment issues, but still, once you understand the macro context, as I mentioned in the macroeconomic analysis 3 course, we also look at growth issues, okay, at some length as well, okay. But I think, okay, I mean, if you are talking about somebody who wants to go and work, let's say, in the cement industry, okay, I mean, obviously, it's not going to be as relevant as for somebody who wants to work in the banking sector. But even in the cement industry, you know, the company will have to engage closely with the banks that finance this the firm, right? And also it has to understand macroeconomic trends and how those trends will impact the company's prospects. So, I mean, it definitely has benefits, but not as much. I think macroeconomic analysis 3 is more beneficial for those who want to work in other sectors, okay, like in industry and so on. But whereas money and banking 1 and 2 are more geared to those who want to work in the banking and financial system or in the MAS. But of course, every course has spillover knowledge into other areas. Well, I mean, as I said, these are fundamental issues, right? I mean, banks will always operate whether or not you have a COVID problem, okay? I remember in my course last semester, I did have a tutorial assignment saying that to what extent are the unconventional monetary policies that were employed in the 2007-08 financial crisis still useful in dealing with the COVID crisis, you know? Okay, so you know, one can learn from past experience and, as I said, adapt what you have learned to the current challenges, right? Okay, and I think the literature on unconventional monetary policies like you know, quantitative easing, targeted asset purchases, troubled asset relief program are fascinating, because there in the 2007-08 crisis, the Federal Reserve and other central banks made a huge leap of imagination and came up with all these policies that were exactly designed to deal with the huge crisis that they were facing. So they thought out of the box, right? So it's very important that policymakers should not be sort of constrained by existing dogmas or existing theories, but they should have the mental courage and the mental imagination, right, to think out of the box and come up with new policies, right, to deal with a vastly different and very, very critical situation. So similarly, I mean, the COVID-19 is also a very big challenge. It has some similarities, but also major differences from the global financial crisis. And again, one has to think out of the box and come out with new responses or adapted responses. So as I said, first of all, they have to be clear why they find the model interesting. They should come into the model with an inquiring mindset. That's very important, okay? With an inquiring mindset, okay? And they should then sort of pursue their curiosity. Let's say in a particular topic, they find it very interesting. Then don't just be confined by what is taught in the lectures or in the readings. Do your own independent further study, okay? I greatly encourage student initiative in pursuing their interest, wherever it might lead them, pursuing their creativity, okay? And as I mentioned, once you're in the course, you have to immerse yourself in it totally, okay? Cultivate refresh your analytical concepts of micro and macro theory, refresh your memory on the mathematical and statistical skills. They have to have both problem-solving ability and good general discussion capabilities, good writing skills, And as I mentioned, they also have a keen interest and awareness of current developments.